Hello, you all techies out there. Would like to welcome you all on my YouTube channel, White Eye Security. Here on this channel, we focus on real technical configuration related to cloud, cloud security, network security, and many more technical topics. So yeah, without further delay, let's get started with our topics for today. And yeah, I would like to thank you in advance for watching. Hello, everyone. Today, we are discussing about analytic rules and hunting queries, which is the second pillar of Microsoft Sentinel we already discussed. So, I mean, after you have connected your data sources, which we did in last few videos to Microsoft Sentinel, I mean, we all now want to be notified if something suspicious is, you know, happening to our environment. So that's when Microsoft Sentinel provides out of the box built-in templates to help you create the threat detection rules. So basically, these threat detection rules are the analytic rules we called. So basically, these rules are again based on KQL queries, and these automatically, you know, search across an environment for the activities those are looking suspicious or to the threats which are there in the environment. So there are, you know, different type of rule types available in Microsoft Sentinel. Some of them you can customize, some of them you can't. Some of them are based on machine learning. So let's, you know, discuss them one by one. So first of all, we have Microsoft security rule. So Microsoft security templates automatically create Microsoft Sentinel incident from the alerts generated in other Microsoft security solution in real time. So let me show you an example. So here we have these five analytic rules already created. So you can see create incident based on Active Directory identity protection, then Cloud App Security, Defender for Cloud, and Defender for Identity. So these are the example of Microsoft security rules. So as it is written, Microsoft security templates automatically creates Microsoft Sentinel incident from the alerts generated in other Microsoft security solution like Defender for Endpoint, Defender for Identity, or, you know, Defender for Cloud Apps, something like that. So next one, let's discuss about fusion rules. So basically, you know, fusions rule are nothing. These are the rules based on machine learning capabilities of this particular product. As we already discussed, Microsoft Sentinel has built-in machine learning properties. So that's when it takes advantage of those capabilities to, you know, detect threats and vulnerabilities. So we can see Microsoft Sentinel uses the fusion correlation engine to detect threats and vulnerabilities across the environment. So these are the rules which we cannot, you know, modify by ourselves, because these are completely based on the machine learning capabilities of this particular product. Next one, similarly, again, machine learning behavior analytics. So there is a little bit difference between the second one and the third one. This is again, I mean, based on machine learning capabilities of Microsoft Sentinel. But basically, how it is different, this, you know, analyze the behavior of any particular user or, you know, device to learn about those things, and then, you know, alert us if some discrepancy or, you know, out of the box actions are there. So basically, suppose as an user, I'm signing in from a particular location from India and from a particular device, and suddenly I started signing in from some different location from China, or, you know, from some different devices. So basically, these are the behavior analysis it kind of, you know, does on behalf of my user and devices, and it will alert, you know, as an incident that, you know, this is what is happening. We didn't see this user doing this kind of a stuff earlier. Now this user is relates to this incident, something like that. Okay, so idea behind these two alerts are machine learning capabilities and machine learning, you know, properties of this particular product. Next one, threat intelligence. So this is again a major, feature of Microsoft Sentinel, that it takes advantage of built-in Microsoft threat intelligence capabilities. So based on, you know, Microsoft threat intelligence, it correlates across our logs. It can be a syslog, it can be a Windows DNS event, domain, IP, and all those things. So it correlates the properties with the threat engine or threat intelligence, you know, it has built in. So basically, you know, Microsoft gathers million and trillion signals every day around the globe to, you know, identify threats, and they keep it. Supposedly it's as a database kind of a thing, or, you know, signals. So it correlates our logs, signals, IP domains with that threat database to detect if, you know, something similar is there in our environment as well. So an example of that, you know, if my firewall logs are there in Sentinel, and from my firewall there is a communication with the IP which is there in threat intelligence database. You know, this is not that is not, you know, a good IP. So it will alert us that we see a communication from your firewall to a IP in China or somewhere else, and that has indicated as a bad IP or, you know, suspicious IP in our threat database. So please take action or investigate into that. Something like that is will do. It will do, and, you know, create an incident based on that. Again, the next one you can see, the rule type is anomaly. So anomaly, again, I mean, rule template uses machine learning to detect specific types of anonymous behavior. So for example, sign-in location, I mean anonymous sign-in, where, you know, there is no information about location and, you know, device or all that stuff available, and users are able to sign in. So this is an example of an anonymous alert, like there is no known parameters on those logs. So this rule type will detect those kind of a things and create an incident based on that to us to investigate. So yeah, this is the another example of a rule type. Next one we have is scheduled. So basically, this is the, what to say, I mean, a most important or used rule you can say, because this is pretty much, you know, customizable. You can customize these rules according to yourself, something you want to see, something you don't want to see, you know, what are the frequency you need to run it, you need to change the frequency, or, you know, you need to increase or decrease the frequency of that alert, how much, you know, time of data you want to, you know, reference it, something like that. So scheduled rules are completely, you know, modifiable. You can modify those according to yourself. You can copy the logic, create another, you know, rule manually with the help of these scheduled rule as well. So basically, these are again also built on logic of KQL. I mean, if you talk about pre-built rule, these are again built by Microsoft security expert. But again, like I said, you can take that query, make your own rule, and, you know, make the changes to those. Why these are called scheduled rule? Because there is a parameter, or you can say option, which is there that you want to run it every 4 hours, every 6 hours, every 12 hours, those kind of a thing. So you can customize that as well. So that's why they are called scheduled rule. They are scheduled to run on a particular date, time, and, you know, event kind of a thing. Our last one we have, near real-time rule type. So again, near real-time rules are also a set of scheduled rules. So, you know, which are kind of a design to run every minute, you can say. So we can, you know, get that incident or information as soon as possible. So yeah, this is why they called near real time. So let me quickly show you where we can see all these rule type option in Microsoft Sentinel. So if I go to Microsoft Sentinel, this is analytic options in this Microsoft Sentinel portal. And if you go to rule template, and if I go to add filter, and if I filter them by rule type, we have six categories there, which we just now discussed: schedule, NRT, fusion, Microsoft security, ML behavior, and threat intelligence. So yeah, there are the different types of you know, rules, analytic rules, which we just discussed. And if you see here, you can see these are the rule templates. You can see the rule type here: fusion, Microsoft security, NRT, ML behavior, and all that stuff. So this is the option where we can see those templates, and, you know, the type of rules which is, you know, associated with those particular templates. I mean, you can see this in use. So whatever analytic rules we are using will be showing here as in use. Otherwise, they will be like this. Once we will create those, like you can see the option create rule, it will be showed as in use. We will be discussing that, you know, how to create these analytic rules in the next upcoming video. For now, let's discuss about the other option, which is there to hunt the threats in Microsoft Sentinel after we have, you know, integrated our log source, which is Azure Sentinel Huntings. So again, I mean, huntings are again based off KQL queries. So basically, these hunting allows us to, you know, manual proactive investigation into possible security threats based on the ingested data, which we have, you know, ingested through data sources, which we just connected in our last videos. So basically, if I tell you in layman language, this is the place, the hunting option, where you can, you know, proactively hunt for your threats. These are again based on KQL queries, completely customizable. You can build your own KQL query to create new hunting queries. So basically completely customizable, or you can create new based on your knowledge of KQL. But again, these are used to do proactive hunting even before an incident is created in Microsoft Sentinel. So basically, as an analyst, as a SOC analyst, if you prefer to hunt down the threats even before they can occur into an environment, you can just take an advantage of hunting queries, run those, and see if any vulnerability is going on, or if you see any threats, or starting of a threat, starting of pattern, or starting of any signals. So you can use these Microsoft Sentinel huntings. Let me quickly show you what is the option in Microsoft Sentinel to use huntings. So here you have option listed as huntings, and you can see what are the different kind of hunting queries are available by default. So right now you can see there are 211 hunting queries available provided by Microsoft security expert by default. And again, as you can see, rare audit activity initiated by app, rare audit activity initiated by user. So quickly you can run these and threat you can analyze or detect those threats even before they can occur to an incident. To run all these at once, you can click on this run all queries, or you can select one by one, whichever you want to run, 1, 2, 3, whatever you want to run, you can just select them and run selected queries. So let me just show you how to run all of them. You can hit run all queries and it will go and run all of those. So okay, once you run all queries, you will see a result like these. So these are the hunting queries which are giving results in your environment. So just you can quickly go and check, like you want to check rare processes running on a Linux host with the new logons and all that stuff. You can go and click on view results and analyze those things. So yeah, we will learn more about these and while we are going to investigate those analytic rules, not analytic rules, those incident and the huntings as well, like how to investigate to the hunting results or to the incident results, which we will get after creating the analytic rules. So yeah, this is basically an idea about the analytics and hunting in Microsoft Sentinel. What are the different options for analytic rules and how we can utilize hunting into our environment. On the next video, we will learn how to create analytic rules and what are the different options, what are the scheduled or rules, how to modify all those. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope this has been informative to you, and I would like to see you on the next one. Thank you.